So here we have Darryl. Darryl's a good golfer, plays on very low handicap, significantly better since he started using plane swing. He's hitting his irons longer, he's got more distance on his drives, and he's far more accurate. That's very positive because he's now swinging in plane. And what we have here is we have it set to Darryl's optimum. Now, it's not an exact science, I have to tell you. Some pros like it a little bit flatter. Okay, that's perfectly fine. You wouldn't want it any more upright than this. Okay, so here we are now, set and ready to go in plane swing. If you just have a little look, I can adjust the back here, and you can see it can go flatter. It could go more upright, but we're going to sit here at the setting of, as it happens, plus two. Darryl's a tall guy. He's got short arms. Right. So here we are. So we now remove the playing guide. And Darryl's now going to build the swing nice and gently, shoulders and arms, all one piece, as we just gradually build the swing. Very important when you're working in plane swing to build gradually. Relax, soft forearms, nice relaxed hands. Good extension through the ball here. Good extension going back. We've got good shoulder turn working. Natural forearm rotation. Not over-exaggerating it. Keep concentrating on that ball, Darryl. And we're just going to add in a bit of wrist hinge. Okay? And as we add in that wrist hinge, and we work the shoulder turn and the forearm rotation, you can see here that the plane checker is in line with the hoop and the setting through Darryl's sternum. Come down and through, Darryl. What you can't see through here is that as Darryl hinges to plane, the plane checker once again is in line with the hoop.